यशोमतीनन्दन गजजनराकल गोकुलनन्दन श्याम
Thank you.
Hare Rama, Rama Rama,
Asukam lokam imam prapya bhajasvamam.
That this world is false, but we can understand from Bhagavad Gita that the world is not false, it is temporary. There is a difference between temporary and false. This world is temporary, and there is another world which is eternal. This world is miserable, but the other world is eternal and blissful. Arjuna was born in a saintly royal family. To him also the Lord says, take to my devotional service and come quickly back to Godhead, back home. No one should remain in this temporary world. Full as it is with miseries, everyone should attach himself to the bosom of the Supreme Personality of Godhead, so that he can be eternally happy. The devotional service of the Supreme Lord is the only process by which all problems of all classes of men can be solved. Everyone should therefore take to Krishna consciousness and make his life perfect.
இவ்வாறு இருக்க புண்ணியமான பிராமணர்கள், பக்தர்கள் மற்றும் புண்ணியமான அரசர்களை பற்றி சொல்வதற்கு என்ன உள்ளது? எனவே துன்பம் வாய்ந்த இந்த தற்காலிகமான உலகம் உலகை அடைந்து நீ எனது அன்பு தொழில் ஈடுபடுவாய்.
Yeah.
Lord Krishna, of course, wants to encourage Arjuna because Arjuna is a saintly king. Of course, he doesn't have any kingdom before the battle of Kurukshetra. Before Kurukshetra war, he was a Kshatriya but with no kingdom. That's why he was speaking Bhagavad Gita to him. Krishna, what did Krishna say? Because you're my devotee as well as my friend, I'm speaking this knowledge to you. Bhaktosi me sakacheti rahasyam hietat uttamam. Bhaktosi me sakacheti, because you're my devotee as well as my friend, I'm speaking this knowledge to you. So we should understand, you may be a brahmana or a devotee or a saintly king, but don't be happy, don't just try to be comfortable here in this world, but understand that the goal is to get out of this world. This world is not our real home. We don't belong here, and we won't be able to stay here forever. one world, leave this body. But don't be worried about it. Be prepared for it to go higher, to go to a better place. Understand the temporary nature of this world. And this world is described here in the verse today, anityam asukam lokam. Anityam, not eternal. Asukam, not, there's no happiness in this world. So there is an eternal world and there is happiness, but you don't find eternal happiness here. We may say, no, I'm happy, I have a nice family, I have a nice home, I have money, I don't have any problem. But we have to understand these things are called temporary. We won't have them forever. We come together and we will be separated in course of time. So we may say, well, I'm not suffering, but there is suffering for everyone. We say there are three kinds of kleshas. Kleshas meaning trouble. There's adibhautik klesha, adiatmik klesha, and adidaivik klesha. The three different types of miseries in the material world. So adidaivik klesha, the miseries due to the material nature. Maybe it's so hot, or sometimes it's so cold some places. Sometimes there are earthquake, or there is a tsunami. There's always disasters coming. Just now we're just getting over the pandemic with the COVID virus. This is the miseries of the material world. So there are miseries also from other living entities, adibhautik. Sometimes the dog, the mad dogs in the street may attack you in the night. And then mosquitoes come and bite you and give you some horrible disease. In other words, you would get malaria and have fevers. Did you have malaria? Headache, terrible headache. Oh, very horrible thing. And then dengue. They don't have any cure for dengue. Many people also die. Dengue, a horrible disease. These are diseases from other living entities. Sometimes neighbors can be horrible. You can have a horrible neighbor who gives you a lot of trouble. We had one neighbor, they didn't let us burn incense. They said that incense is terrible. You cannot burn the incense. And they don't want to hear the noise of the kirtan. Outside there'll be so much noise, the trucks, the motorbikes, but a little kirtan, oh, horrible, terrible. So misery is from other living entities. Sometimes you have to work with people who are horrible people. You have worked for people, maybe your boss is wicked and nasty. So this is all adibhautik klesha. And then there's the misery of the body, adiatmik. Headache, backache, leg ache, knee ache, the whole body is just made to give you pain. This one little infection in your foot, you suffer so much. And to get happiness in the body, very difficult. But to get pain, very easy. The whole body is meant to give us pain and trouble. So we have to understand this material body, this is not our real self. Krishna says in the Bhagavad Gita, Vachamsi Janani Yaha Vihaya Navani Trinati Naroparani Tata Sharirani Jahaya Janani Anyani Samyati Navani Dehi. Just like we give up the cloth, we change the dress, so we change also the body. When the cloth becomes old and worn out, you get a new cloth. In the same way, when the body becomes old and worn out, we get a new body. What kind of body do you want to get in the next life? It will depend on how we use this body. We get the results of the work we do in this body in the next life. So this body is like the karma kshetra. Kshetra means the field. This body is a field of work. And the activities, the work we do with the body in this life will determine the body we get in the next life. So, Lord Krishna is saying that if we do devotional service unto Him, then we won't have to come back again. We should understand we've come to this world. We've come to this world. Actually, we made a mistake to come here. So, now that we're here, we just have to do whatever devotional service we can and get out. Srila Prabhupada gives an example. He said, just like if you go in the public toilet in India, so you don't waste time. You don't just enjoy the air there. It's not a very pleasant place. But you have to use the toilet, so you just do what you have to do and get out. So same way, we come in this material world. We should just do devotional service, use it for devotional service, and use this body for some devotional service, and get out of this world. We don't want to have to keep coming back into this kind of place. Now we have the human body, but there's no guarantee in the next life we will again get the human body. Just because we have a human body now doesn't mean we'll get the human body in the next life. We may come back in the dog body or the tree body. We know the Vedas say 84 lakh species of life. Only 4 lakh species are human. So it's rare to get the human body. And it's even more rare to get association with devotees. In the association of devotees, we can get out of the field of birth and death. We say, Bajahure mana Srinanda Nandana Abaya Charanara Vindure Durlapa Manava Janama Satsange Taraho Ye Babo Sindure. This is a song by a Greek devotee, Govinda Das. He's saying that it's very rare to get the human birth. Now, even rare to get the association of devotees. Not the devotees are everywhere. There's many places there are no devotees. Even in Malaysia, there are places where there are no devotees. So we're fortunate to have nice devotee temple association. We have all facility. Krishna conscious. We have to take full advantage of this opportunity. Don't waste the valuable time. Because now is Kali Yuga. And Kali Yuga will last for another 427,000 years. Four lakh 27,000. Kali Yuga is 432,000 years, and we've already passed 5,000 years. So 427,000 years are remaining. And as Kali Yuga progresses, the situation will become worse.
Yeah.
Already we can see so much degradation in the world, how people have become very irreligious. Meat eating, everybody is doing. And even they kill the cow. And then everyone's taking all different kinds of intoxication. And gambling is going on all the time. And illicit sex, so going on constantly. And we see so many sins going on. You have abortions taking place, the women have abortions, they kill their babies. People don't know how to cook anymore. They just go and eat everything, and it's 7-Eleven. Go to the convenience store, purchase some junk food. People spend all their time with their mobile phones playing games, young children even. They used to play the mobile phone, used to play games on the mobile phone. People don't like to hear the Shastra, they don't sit and read the book anymore. If you ask people, give donation for the temple, oh no, no, I can't give any money for temple. But they'll go to the mall, they'll go shopping, they'll spend hundreds and thousands. And they will spend hours and hours in cinema and watching cricket matches, but they cannot spend half an hour to sit in the temple. People don't even wash, don't even bathe regularly, they won't take bath regularly. So everything gets worse, the Kali Yuga goes on. And gradually people all go on, they will live underground. Now, of course, they're building up, they're building the houses up, the condominium, they're living up in the air. But in the future, they'll live down. They'll go down. You're living in the ground. And people will all have to leave. They'll all leave the cities. They'll go to live in the forest. There'll be no more. There'll be no future anymore. There won't be jobs. The factories will all close.
Yeah, very likely.
encourage people of natural living, high thinking, natural living. Don't waste all the energy, all the resources of the world. Use everything carefully for the service of Krishna. In the Ishopanishad, it is stated, Ittavashyam idam sarvam yat kincha chagat yam chagat tena chaktena punjata makridaha kasha sutanam. Everything animate and inanimate that is within the universe is controlled and owned by the Lord. One should accept, therefore, only those things necessary for himself, and one should not accept more, knowing well to whom they belong. So we have to take our quota. Don't take more. Don't be greedy to get more. Be satisfied to live basic life. How many houses can you live in? People have one house here, another house there. They go to Mayapur, they buy a house. They go to Vrindavan, buy another house. And they're living all the time in some other place. They never live there. They buy the house, but they don't live there. They're living in some other city somewhere where they make money. But they like to buy the house in Vrindavan. They're thinking, when I'm old, when I retire, I will go there. But maybe they'll die before that. Don't know what's going to happen. But people are so greedy. We want more. We want to have more. One house is not enough. So this is the problem. Because people are so greedy, they may exploit. We take more than we need. And this creates problems. People will say, money is not enough, we need more money. Husband gets one job, wife will complain, money is not enough. Husband gets another job, one job in the day, another job in the night. Money is still not enough. Husband gets another job, a job on the weekend as well. Poor husband working all the time, wife is getting money, not enough, bring more, bring more. That's the problem, that's the world. And the politicians are always telling us, just work harder, just work harder, keep working, work harder. He said, I'm already working so hard. He said, just keep going, a bit more, a bit more. It's like the man is riding on the horse. He holds the carrot in front of the horse. The horse goes forward to get the carrot. But the carrot always goes forward.
Or
It's like the fox was trying to get the grapes. The grapes were growing up. The fox jumped up, tried to get the grape, couldn't get. Then he thought, anyway, grapes must be sour.
Fox.
The sour grapes, you see. You don't can't get what you want, so you say it must have been sour. It's no good anyway. And this way they feel no problem. So we try to avoid, try to hide the miseries of the material world. But we have to know that these miseries are there for everyone. For everyone. There's birth, old age, disease, death. Birth was suffering. Child in the womb suffering. Child comes out of the womb, still suffering. So many pains, he cannot talk yet, he cannot tell the mother what he wants.
Cannot talk?
No, well, they can't. The child may cry, but the mother doesn't know why the child is crying. Mother thinks one thing, but it's another thing. Other things, our child is hungry, but the child is not hungry, some other problem. Then the child grows up, he has to go to school, that's another trouble. Go to school, teachers, bossing, telling me what to do, stand up, sit down, read, write. Now the children know how to have iPad. They use the iPad to go to school to do the work. They don't write, they just use the iPad. So many troubles are there throughout the life. The child grows up, he goes to school, so much competition. Did you do good? Did you get good marks? The pressure is on the child to do well. Parents want the child to be a good student. They want to send the child to go to college, get education. So constant suffering. Then the child has to go to college and has to pay a lot of money and study a lot and take so many exams. Then he has to go and try to find a job. I met the one devotee in Delhi. They got the job. They said, I worked very hard to get a job in a big company. I worked very hard. I got a job in one of these big companies, multinational companies in Delhi. But then after a month in the job, oh, it was so horrible, so much stress. I don't want to do it anymore. Okay, any questions? problem?
No problem. It's a full of problem.
You didn't improve, or
my husband.
Your husband. Oh. Well, the problem is sometimes we have too much expectation about other people. Yeah, Hare Krishna. Sometimes our expectations are too high for other people. You know, you have to be tolerant about other people, your husbands. you have to be satisfied that you're doing it yourself. By you doing devotion, your husband also gets some benefit. You see? You share. Husband and wife, they share each other's pious activities. So whatever you're doing, your husband also gets some benefit from it. So, but you know, to get your husband to do these things, you know, you can't force. There was this one girl, she got this married woman, she got some cancer. So her husband used to be very unfavorable. But now that she's got this cancer, she's in this condition, health is bad, she's going taking chemotherapy. So husband become more favorable to her spiritual practice. So he's encouraging her more with her spirit. Before he used to criticize her. But since she got the cancer, she became quite ill. So the husband became much kinder to her. He's encouraging her also with her spiritual practice. And she could talk to him. And he appreciates when she tells him about her spiritual. So when they're in a crisis like that, then the husband has to change his heart. That's one example. But there are many others.
I must be dead. I want to be dead.
There's no such thing as chance. You know, there's a reason for everything. So, yes, there's some reason for it. It's not just, oh, chance or luck or bad luck. Of course, there is some things, you know, the vastu, the architecture, the design of the building. You want to arrange the building in such a way, just like if you go to Cambodia, you know, they have the Angkor Wat. So that temple, they built that temple exactly according to vastu. So every morning when the sun rises, it comes right just behind the temple. And you see the sun appear over the temple. So usually, yeah, the deity should be facing the sun, as you can see the sun. The deity should see the sun. The deity is facing the sun.
Yes, that one is, yeah, it's facing. But then the lighting, I facing the sun as well. Is it right or
not? The lighting?
Yeah.
Well, you don't need the lighting if you have the sun.
Good.
In the old temples, they didn't have lighting. They didn't have electric lights. They just have oil lamps. They put oil lamps. Krishna is concerned about the devotion. He doesn't worry so much about the rules and regulations. But the devotion is an important thing. Right? That you have the devotion. You have the mood. Please Krishna. I'm trying to please Krishna. That's an important thing. Krishna doesn't worry so much about all these details. And Prabhupada also didn't care so much about all the details. The important thing was the mood of devotion. Okay. Hare Krishna, Srimad Bhagavatam. Yeah.